Welcome. Please choose your language.
Deutsch ist ausgewählt. Einen Moment bitte. Herzlich willkommen in der Bäckerei Digital.
Do you like nuts? I've got some deluxe nuts for you. The usual everything applies, meat sticks, carrot sticks. This time I do have some deluxe nuts if you wanna munch on something. I think this is gonna be a long weekend for me. So I'm starting with something light. This is from Rogue Brewery. It's called Dreamland. It's just like a lager. Light, smooth, easy. I'm showing records, just a handful, several I don't know if I've even really talked too much about. This is kind of getting repetitive. This, you know, can't believe I'm doing another one of these self-indulgent douche-isodes. So a couple holes that I had that I wanted to slide something into. I got a couple items from the collection that I listened to, and then one new-ish release came out 2 or 3 months ago in 2019. So I guess same thing applies again with the children. If you can reach it, you can drink it, that whole thing. So first, a hole that I needed to fill was this Kikakumoyo House in the Tall Grass. Just didn't have this on vinyl. I saw that they had a few copies left of the Creamy Red Splatter, limited to 500. So I bought it, you know. Japanese psychedelic music. Showing them before other people talk about this stuff. I like the center label on that. Our friend Snowy over at Psychedelic Snow, he's been showing Brian Jonestown Massacre records. And I think previously, maybe almost a year ago, I was commenting that I had seen this and I had planned to pick it up, and then one day it just wasn't there. And then online it was, you know, it was ridiculously expensive for these reissues. But now I guess they repressed, because he had gotten one, and then that prompted me to look again, and then they were everywhere. So this is the Brian Jonestown Massacre, their Satanic Majesty's Second Request. This is from 1996. I think it's their fourth LP. It's the second of three that they released in 1996. You know, it's heavily influenced by like this. As a Satanist, it's really important for me to have this in the collection. You know, if I'm gonna have their Satanic Majesty's First Request, I feel like I should have their Second Request as well on vinyl. I mean, I've had this for a long time. I've had the CD for a long time. So this is at times a bit odd, almost comical. And then at other times, it's just amazing. So, yeah. This is on black vinyl. Double LP, 180 gram vinyl.
Thank you.
next up, this is just something that I pulled to listen to that I thought I'd show. This is from Luke Haynes, who is in The Auteurs, and then later in Black Box Recorder, or that's like his project, basically. It's called Bader Meinhof. This came out in 1996. It's a one-off, so just this album, Bader Meinhof, so that it's named after, a German terrorist organization, like the Red Army faction. Kind of tells the story of that terrorist group, which is kind of an odd, it's kind of an odd topic to take on, to you name your band basically after that, and then that's what it is. It's pretty good. Sounds a lot like The Auteurs, maybe a little bit more, some electronics, maybe. Yeah. It's the inner sleeve.
For hours, and we talk religiously, and he said, could I take out every woman and child in the border town for the right to be governed, waste them without mercy.
Another one I was just, I pulled, this is actually, so this is Circulatory System, Mosaics Within Mosaics. This came out in 2014. It's a double LP. It's like psychedelic pop with a load of weirdness, a little lo-fi. You get short bursts of experimentation and then short bursts of like pop psych. It's Will Cullen Hart of the Olivia Tremor Control. What made me want to listen to this, I saw their debut LP, which I think is just self-titled Circulatory System, being reissued. Well, issued for the first time on vinyl. They did a Kickstarter campaign, and I had toyed with doing the Kickstarter thing. And I was thinking about Chris over at Dixieland Farm. He had shown That Dog, the new That Dog record, and he did that Kickstarter. And I think he said it took 2 years to get it. So I decided I'd wait to see how things shook out. This is really like that first record is a lot more accessible than their second or their third record. It's on black vinyl. I like the labels, however, no, it does. It does say it says side three, side four, side one, side two. So that's handy. You don't have to guess. Last one for today. This is the one that came out, I think it came out in November 2019. This is a female duo. I think one of them is from Sweden and the other one is from Spain. It's called Decatapult. DKXD is the name of the album. So, kind of loosely think something like Kraftwerk, Daft Punk, crossed or some melding with like Chibo Motto. So there's a lot of weird topics. Food. That's kind of, it makes me think of that. Or like Devo or Ladytron, like some of that, some new wave pop elements with a broader electronic experimental little bit. You can see, I had to order this. I actually told this story and cut it out of the last one, or part of this story. Some of these records that this is a European issue, that some of them are hard to get, except from the worst of the worst sellers that you can find online. So this arrived to me. This is VG Plus. I don't know if you'll be able to see. It's like dinged up. But what's worse is I ordered it. It probably took 6 weeks to get here. Like, they marked it as shipped a week after I placed the order. I actually ordered this and another item. So a week after they marked them as shipped, then a week after that, they refunded me for the other record. Didn't tell me anything. You can still order that other record that they refunded me on the same site that I ordered it. So I'm completely out of, which is Amazon. I'm completely at a loss as to why they canceled the one. I'm not gonna reorder it from them. This is the inner sleeve. Rare Waves. This was Movie Mars, but Rare Waves also had this, but Rare Waves has screwed me hard more than once. So I go out of my way not to use them. So I went Movie Mars. I don't know what to say. I guess what I'm trying to say here is, if at all possible, like if you're in the United States, I would avoid Movie Mars. I think it's Movie Mars CDs, that's the seller. Or Rare Waves, both of which seem like legitimate large companies. I mean, I'm sure they are legitimate companies. But, and maybe that's their game, that they can kinda, they got some sort of angle they're working where they're slow on shipping and cancel things for no reason. This is limited edition. 500 copies. It has a giant, this whole white box here on the back. I don't like that. That's where it has it numbered. 294 out of 500. Today, I think I've got maybe one or two more self-indulgent douche-isodes in the hopper. I hope you like my nuts. They are deluxe nuts. If you didn't partake in the nuts, I hope you like, nibbled on a meat stick, sampled some different beers. I feel like this one whatever. Thanks for watching. I know this is, amateur hour. Probably see you again in the near future. Cheers.